hello, hello, everybody. Welcome to What's the Scoop. Today I have my friend Tayon here.
Hey.
She is a stylist and she has a degree in merchandising. Whole lot of other shit I probably don't know nothing about.
Merchandising, textiles, and design.
See?
From the University of Arkansas at Pine Bluff.
Whoop, whoop.
Yeah.
So we support HBCUs and all that good shit. Today we are making oxtails.
Yes, they are.
Tayon wanted to make oxtails, so we go
get it. This bitch cook like an auntie. This is about the only thing I do not know how to make, so she has to teach me.
Yeah.
So, yeah.
But let me get this sheet, and we're going to do it. Today, we are going to be talking about loyalty.
Okay.
These are the seasonings I'm going to be using. Get the gist.
Mm-hmm. A little garlic. Black pepper.
It's time.
Okay, and then we got some cayenne pepper.
This salt.
Mm-hmm.
Brown mustard.
Brown mustard.
Allspice.
And some allspice.
Alright, now cleaning oxtails is extremely hard. I had the butcher cut mine in half. Because I didn't feel like, I feel like it'll be a little easier. And it was, surprisingly.
Mm-hmm.
So let me get some kitchen shears.
I already washed my hands, but I'm washing again on camera because we know how y'all people be. We know how y'all be.
I need to you ain't wash your hands.
Like, yeah, I did. You just ain't see. But you know, it's all good.
It's your house clean. That's the real
okay.
Did you wash your hands?
All right.
Yeah, grandma said, girl, I thought she was. She said, I came in your bathroom. She said, girl, I had to look. She said, did y'all show this around the house? She said, I checked the toilet seat, made sure it wasn't no rain on there. She said, girl, the girl is clean. I said, I don't know if I'm saying that as a compliment.
Like, I can live with you. Come on now.
Like, I'm supposed to be dirty. This one is real fatty. Which one did I not play? So, oxtails have a lot of fat on them. I tried to get most of the fat off outside of this little top piece. That shit is hard. I'm trying to find the one I did. It's only about one left. I think this one may be that one.
And she trying to save it for me.
Yeah, that one is it. This the one. So when you clean it, you cut the skin or the fat skin. And it's easy if you go left to right or, you know, side to side, whatever the fuck. Now at the top, you ain't gonna be able to cut it because it's like a little bone. It's like bone marrow.
Mm-hmm.
But you try to cut as much fat off as possible. Be careful not to cut the meat because the shit is a little tear. See that? Like, cut a whole piece of meat.
Yes, we gon' dig.
So I'm gonna try to maneuver that around. Yeah. Now I hate the extra fat and shit on my food. Like, chicken, I've been trying to clean my chicken so damn good because,
yeah.
It be chicken thighs, especially chicken thighs. They so damn good.
Yeah, if y'all don't clean y'all meat, we can't eat at your house. Y'all don't clean y'all meat. No. Y'all love the braised right.
I clean most of my meat in salt water, soaking in salt water.
The only meat you should not be cleaning is ground beef.
I'm going to say, yeah, and I try to rinse that bitch off every now and
then. Okay.
Most of this meat is ground, for real. Ain't nobody, that shit look too
okay.
Real.
Okay.
Rinse this shit off. I already got the flour. Now, goddamn loyalty.
Mm-hmm.
Loyalty is a broad statement. Yeah, it is very, very simple. You love a motherfucker, you respect them, you loyal to them. It's just that simple.
I don't understand why some of you motherfuckers just can't get it.
I feel as if you can't have loyalty without love.
Mm-mm.
I'm going to ask Tayon a couple questions here in a second, but it's a little out of here. I'm just spending my opinion on it. I don't feel like you can have loyalty without love. I don't feel like you can be loyal to a person you just met. I don't think that loyalty is as complicated as you make it seem. Now, it becomes complicated when we talk about blind loyalty. You know, loyalty ain't just you shutting the fuck up and saying, okay, girl. No, if your friend wrong and you know that bitch wrong, you tell the bitch. You're wrong. You dead ass wrong. I ain't seen the motherfucker more wrong than you are in this moment. Now, you ain't got a corrector in front of people. Shekinah.
Yeah, that's what you don't do. That's what you don't do, especially if them your real friends. Do not check them in front of people. You take that shit to the side on the private. Now, girl, you know you was not. You know I ain't say nothing in front of them. Either way it go, I'm going to be the bitch up for you. But
still again, you dead.
So you know you was dead ass wrong. Yeah, just that simple. Like that.
You ain't got a, oh, bitch, you dead, so you. Ooh.
No.
I forgot the allspice was a little bit more open. So we
just. Yeah, baby, it's open for sure.
Yeah, sure. We're going to mix this bitch up.
But what they be saying, if you ain't sneezing, it ain't seasoned. So, you know, and we ain't sneezed yet. So.
It's seasoned.
Yeah, I can feel it. It's tickling.
So I don't like touching my meat. That's why I season it in this big ass bowl.
And it's probably not the only difference of us in the kitchen
because
I will stick my hairs in there.
Yeah, I don't like when I'm seasoning it, I just don't like touching it. I mix that shit up. I'm going to put a little bit more on there because I like mine seasoned.
Mm-hmm.
And not too much more allspice because.
Yeah, you don't kill us with that.
Yeah, one. I put a little bit. And you got to put it in the fucking sauce when you're making the gravy.
And if you can't see your seasoning on your meat,
it ain't seasoned.
It's not fucking seasoned.
Put a little bit more on there. Just a.
Little
bit. Okay. You know? Now, back to this goddamn loyalty. Mm-hmm. Blind loyalty. Don't just follow behind a nigga because he got a little change. Now, if a nigga has something you want to get and you're aspiring to be where he's at, there is nothing wrong with being loyal to that man.
And learning how to get there.
You learn. You don't try to take what the nigga got. You niggas be trying to take what. Bitches too. Y'all be trying to take what the next motherfucker got. No, mm-hmm. You wait your turn. You sit your turn and wait. Ain't nothing down. Ain't nothing wrong to wait until you come up. You motherfuckers don't like to wait. I don't like to use that much salt.
You're supposed to be patient. Patience is a virtue.
It is. It's a good virtue.
If you want to be close to God, you need to be patient.
And if some of you niggas, people, don't believe in God, that's perfectly
whoever
fine.
You believe in.
If you want to be close to the universe,
you need to be patient.
You have to learn how to be powerful. I say the universe a little bit more tricky. That motherfucker got too much.
We ain't
even
finna go here today.
You ain't gonna be waiting all day, bitch. Get my Jesus.
Give it here now.
I need my shit right now. I ain't got time to wait up for Pookie Nim next week.
Cause they gonna be playing.
I ask the motherfucker a question. If you don't answer fast,
what they say? It's my money and I need it now. Right now. When they don't say, we can't talk about a relationship, the funds is due today.
That motherfucker said, you what he said?
You talking about you want to do this, that, and the third, but where is the funds? The he bills said, is due today.
He said, okay. The bills was due yesterday, not tomorrow. So send the motherfucking funds
today.
That motherfucker.
You want to talk to me? We got to see some green, okay?
Now, we're gonna put a little season on the line because we black.
Yeah, of course.
Turn this goddamn stove on. I got my cast iron skillet.
Mm-hmm.
Of course. I don't use.
You wanna put a little bit of everything?
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
You want something to drink? I got some water. I got some Kool-Aid.
Let me get that ghetto juice.
What they say, some collard. Got. I was gonna put some little fruits and vegetables. I was gonna put some fruit in here, but I made it for a mixer when we drink it.
Mm-hmm.
Cause that's tequila straight. It's too much for me. Yes, I got a McDonald's cup in my house.
Who don't?
Kiss my ass. So.
And if you don't, you not living right.
You don't. You want the glass or the cup?
You know it don't matter to me.
Take my glass. I stole this. I ain't gonna tell y'all where you bitches like to snitch.
Y'all know that girl, Brie?
She be stealing. Girl, I stole that motherfucker right out.
It's how you supposed to do the allspice, right?
Yeah, just you don't put it. Too much.
Just tap it. There we go. That's it right there. Let's take that.
Cayenne pepper. I have the vegetables pre-cut.
got the Holy Trinity in there.
Mm-hmm. With some carrot. I got the habanero in the sink. We got cut up.
I'm like, what?
That's salt.
Yeah. I knew I wasn't tripping, but the name threw me out.
This happened to put her salt in the old garlic.
I'm ghetto. My grandma told me reduce, reuse, recycle.
I know that's right.
She already knew what it was. She put the salt out here. I said, yeah. I ain't even asked, Grandma, what the hell is this? Let me go rub my nose real quick.
Yeah. Y'all see she leaving to go blow her nose?
Now, Tayana, what is your views on loyalty, your perception of loyalty?
For me, if you like and love the person that you with, it should be no problems with respecting them in their face and outside of their face. You shouldn't just be, oh, bae here, so let me act right. Hell no, you should act right whether they with you or not.
Yeah, that is true.
And my, like, for me, it don't really matter. Well, it does matter what the other person doing, because baby, I'm gonna match your energy real quick. Real quick. But off tops, my morals, yeah, if I'm with somebody, I'm with that person. I don't see nobody else. Like, yeah, my eyes still work, and I can be like, ooh, okay. That person cute, this, that, third. But best believe my man.
You can look and don't touch.
Okay, my man's still going to be the finest out of everybody. And that's just on me, you know? And then as far as friendships, bitch, once we meet, because I'll tell anybody that meet me, I'm a vibe person. If we vibing our backs, oh, we finna be cool. We finna be thick as thieves, love. Let's get it.
She a damn lie. She lying. Cause that motherfucker, you piss her ass off and she'll tell you,
Exactly.
Fuck all them vibes, bitch. Put your ass on. Don't talk to me. Don't look
cause
at me.
Cause your vibe is off. I was getting there. If the vibe is off, we not vibing. It's not going down. It's not happening. It's not going to work.
Never.
Like.
Now, I am more so of a,
I'm not a fake, phony, kicker person.
No, nah, we're going to clear up all this animosity.
Real quick. Because, baby, I can't sit in the same room with you. No. Mm-mm. I like positive vibes. And if you're not giving me that, you got to go. Because you're not interrupting my energy. Nah, we're not doing that. I'm a lucky Libra. And, yeah, we're going to keep it same real quick. And if anything out of place, out of order, we're going to get it back together. Because, nah, I cannot. I can't.
Yeah, I don't really like relationship wise. I feel as if now you shouldn't be loyal to no nigga. If that nigga got 6-7 other bitches,
yeah, no.
You go find you 2-3 other niggas and you go have fun. Ain't nothing wrong with keeping your eggs in a couple of different baskets.
But once you know you got your one, don't keep playing.
Yeah.
Do not keep playing. No, that's gonna end up bad for all parties.
Cause you gonna fuck around and don't be out here fucking 4, 5, 6 different people. You got a boyfriend or a girlfriend. Mm-hmm. Cause you gonna fuck around and catch that shit.
You gonna fuck around and find out. Real quick.
You gonna be, woo-wee.
Wait.
I got that shit, Jesus. What is going on?
Lord. You gonna fuck around and play a dangerous fucking game, and that's not okay. You playing with your life.
Small pieces first.
Okay. You play with your life, your partner, life, and everybody else involved, like, and that's just not okay.
And then you don't know how many people that other person is involved with.
Either. Okay. And then these soul ties is real, love.
Them
diseases. That's diseases, soul ties.
All that.
Fucking every STD you can name, you not want it. Like, no. Keep yourself safe. Keep your partner safe. And that just all goes back to the loyalty.
Yeah, because if you say you love a motherfucker,
you can't love somebody if you can't keep your business to yourself.
Yeah, and loyalty, you ain't gotta fuck up. Like, if you ain't dating and y'all talking,
cool. Keep doing what you're doing.
You go talk to a motherfucker. You ain't gotta fuck nobody. That's y'all problem.
Yeah, y'all just gotta throw it back on everybody. Keep your fucking legs closed. And men, keep your shit zipped the fuck up.
Because then y'all end up kids and shit.
Now it's a whole different story.
I didn't know she was like that. I know that bitch was crazy. You knew that bitch was crazy.
You knew what was up.
You just wanted that pussy.
Okay.
You weren't worried about that bitch being crazy.
Like, it's
broad. But also with niggas, I say niggas and females, when it come to y'all friends, you can tell if a person is love to you by the conversation.
Very much so.
If a person don't support you and nothing you do, or if you say you want to do something and they don't ask you, you know, have you really thought about that? They just, oh, yeah, yeah, or...
Because best believe, we going to be like, bitch, you sure you want to...
Oh, well, nigga...
Did you really think about that before you put this to the table?
Yeah, like, ain't nothing wrong with asking your friend that, are you sure? That ain't down to nobody.
Because if you don't ask the if you sure, you not a real friend. Yeah. Especially if you already in your head like, I don't think that's going to go right.
Yeah.
I don't think that's going to be right. Let them know. Because at the end of the day, that's still your friend. And y'all, yeah, that might be their idea, but you are the angel on the shoulder. To make sure that that's really what it is.
Just because they got the idea don't mean they should be doing it.
Exactly.
Because all ideas ain't good ideas. Hell, when I was a kid,
girl.
Oh, my God. Chopped down the bitch with some dishwasher with. It was not a good idea. It wasn't. I put that shit in my book bag. Khalilah looked through my book bag. She said, I just knew you was going to do some stupid shit. That's true loyalty.
Yeah.
Let me stop you from doing so stupid when we both get out. Because she's going to get her ass whooped, too.
For letting you do it.
Mm-hmm.
Ooh, mm-hmm. And if y'all, mm-hmm. if your friend shit's not like that, mm-hmm. to where your mama whoop your friend ass too,
woo, you know how many times I done got my ass whooped with Jay.
So let me tell y'all, me and Bree met through my best friend.
Yeah.
We wasn't this, but now we this, and that bitch be mad because we be hanging out without her. But.
Don't even talk about you, Jay, bitch.
We still love you.
We love you, ho.
We love you, but. Yeah, like, if she's talking crazy going through something, my mama's gonna get on her ass too. Just like her grandma would be looking at me fucking crazy, get on my ass too.
Bro,
that's what it is.
They know my first of all, Tay. I don't know my grandma don't give a fuck.
At all, she don't give a fuck.
She just smack the fuck out of me, damn, little friend. Hey, friend. You around old people, you might wanna watch your mouth. That's my grandma. Tay, other grandma, she just look at you. You don't even say shit around Janice. And if your friends don't respect your family, that ain't loyal to you, bro.
No. Cause this fool, my grandma got a white room.
Hey, I don't know if it's rich.
This girl, every time she come over, we all walking through there. I can't afford nothing in there. I'm not going in there. No, no. Hey, Miss Janice, how you doing? Go sit down. Like, girl, that is not you. That is not you.
Hey, Miss Janice, how you
cause
doing?
Cause if I'm in the house by myself, she's gonna walk in every time I'm like, what's up, bitch? We're putting smoke in. Like, no. Don't get in here acting crazy because my grandma's sitting in here. Let's be real.
Hello, Miss Janice. How are you today? Oh, my God. No.
Let's be real.
I haven't done anything with that. Girl, you know I'm barely. I just smoke a little weed. Yeah, Miss Janice.
We can't even act crazy because I walk in her grandma's house like this. So. Hey, Grandma, how you doing? Because,
We don't do that. Now,
it's a cold switch with the families, you know.
I like this one. Now, here in a second, Tay, our man's gonna be showing us. What the fuck she gonna be showing us? Outfit. She gonna do a couple on me and a couple on her. Bitches really don't be knowing how to dress. So I decided to have this segment. You can be mad all you want. I said what I said. I do not care.
I mean, she ain't telling y'all shit but the truth, because that's the whole reason why I even went and got my degree. Okay?
A lot of people
can't work. Because, I want to be a personal stylist. But I'm not going to be that personal stylist that's just grabbing this, just down the third, and be like, yeah, here you go. This is what you're going to, this is what you're going to wear. I like to get to know my clients. So the fact that me and Bree is like this, and I could tell her, nah, love, that's not it. That's not going to go. But what we're going to do, for me, I already have basically my first outfit on. I'm just going to be showing y'all a couple mix and match options. So we're going to take this from you know, a day after lunch with the girls, a little cute air run to a nighttime. And then I got a couple of different, you know, shirts and shoes, which but our basic item for this outfit will be these pants. Like, I'm just gonna show you how to dress them up, dress them down. And as far as for brief, it's just gonna be a give me a subject, or, you know, say it's date night, or tell me you finna go out of town, and where we going, and what the occasion is, and I'ma get her dressed like that. So, I mean, even, and then with the loyalty too, when you got friends that believe in you, cause so mean that she didn't believe in me, I wouldn't be here, and then just a couple weeks ago, y'all, me and this girl are city gear. Black Friday, matter of fact, it's city gear. And this man in there, we have to check out. Get ready to go. This man in there, he, I guess he rapped or whatever. He had a show coming up. He's trying to get his little outfit together. This fool goes tell him, but he already tell me, you can go help him because I don't know what the fuck he got in his hand, but that ain't that.
Y'all, so right here I'm just browning the oxtails and showing y'all how I brown them. I got a little extra seasoning crumbs in the pan, but that's normal. You want that, make sure you have that, okay? All right, y'all, so I have browned the oxtails. Right here I am just sauteing the vegetables. Now you want to saute your vegetables for at least 4 to 5 minutes. I like to make sure that all mines get well incorporated, sauteed together, so I'm trying to mix the vegetables in there, you know, real fancy like. In a couple of seconds I'm going to be adding some habanero and red bell peppers. Now when you are making this, you are going to add 1.5 cup of red cooking wine. I use 1 2/3 cup, and 1 cup of beef broth. I use 1 1/3 cup of beef broth, because I added a little bit more in the pan when I was done cooking it. You see, I just added the vegetables in there. Now, I did have some crumbs on the side of my pan. I cleaned them off because I seen it, because that's just ghetto. The pan got a little hot. I got this glove my grandma got me. And, yeah, here's the beef broth in there, and we done.
We big. We big. Tell y'all, I'm just finna establish a couple outfits. Now, this right here, she gonna explain. I'm just sit down and finish my drink.
This is the, you know, little out to eat, out to shopping with the girls type day. You know, just a little real simple, real cute. You know, I'm still chilling, but I'm Mrs. Put That On. You know, one of them. So, you got the one. Hold on. Got a little swishy pants. You cannot go wrong with a little cartoon character shirt. Jean jacket, always for the men. Okay? And then we finna change these shoes out and make it a date night real quick.
All right. Don't mind
the black. My toes is all good. So, date night. shirt, you know, take a little bit, turn the shoes out, a little cute. And then, you know, whatever bag or whatever, but I'm in three shits, so I was not lugging all of my shit over here. So, it's a quick little, simple switch out, one, two, you know.
All right, y'all, so right here, I was tipsy and I was making me another drink. I was showing y'all the liquors. That's some shit that I just randomly bought one day. And I was being spontaneous, but I love me a Jack and Coke. Now, since I don't drink pop no more, I do Jack and juice. But y'all can see, a bitch ain't showing a Jack. A bitch ain't showing a Jack. Now, that's some Kool-Aid because I'm ghetto, but that shit was delicious. I'm gonna top it off with a little bit more Jack. I tried to move the chair out the way, and there it is.
Okay. So this one right here is a. I actually wore this to Lizzo concert. So this is one of those fall outing type outfits. You know, get your little puffer. Cause it's just a little wind, it ain't cold, you know, just be a little slow. Just a little sound. Still got your squishies. And these are actually boots. Ain't nothing special. Just like the last heels. These came from Mary's. If y'all in Cloud Love Arkansas, y'all know what I'm talking about. Yeah.
What the hell is a Mad Ranks?
Baby. The best store you can go to find you something to wear. Because you're not going to find much. But you're going to go to Mad Rags, you're going to find you something.
Oh, it's a good place.
Tell me.
Are you the shoes.
Can I get a real?
a normal day, but we gotta up it up a little bit because we performing. So it's like, I want your experience to be about you.
Drunk as hell rambling on about some good bullshit, but nevertheless, my friend Tayana is a stylist, so if you need her to style you, her Instagram's at the beginning of the video. Now right here, we drunk as fuck, so y'all about to listen to us talk about some drunk ass bullshit, but enjoy.
I need the shoes, I need the shirt, I need the pants.
Yeah, I keep everything you
want
to go get for.
It's mine. Keep it the weave. The weave. Bitch, the utensils for the kitchen. I'm keeping all that. Only thing you can take is the furniture and your clothes. Bitch, get the step because I can get another couch. And I'm getting a couch. I ain't worried about no couch. Say, I ain't gonna let you keep the couch. Hey, bro, hey, my pastor.
What Medina say? You bought this hand. You bought this hand. Girl, I'm gonna put that shit down the middle.
He said he came home, it wasn't shit left but some napkins and some paper plates. And some paper folks. She took everything. She took the couch, the furniture, moved all that shit in the storage. Bitch, she had him and his brake pads. That's it. That is it. I said, I know that's highly achieved. You know you'll get a nigga who'll give you some shit. But a lot of these niggas become in a relationship with them, they game, and they clothes. That's it. That's it. Niggas don't be having no money. You done helped a nigga get his job, making $20 an hour. You done helped the nigga get his little real money so he can, you know, do his extracurricular activities and shit, you know, pay for his extra schooling and shit because he went to college and whatnot. And then this motherfucker won't play with you. Money and I gotta go somewhere. picture. I didn't know what to wear. I had this all black little jump. I'm like, oh no, I didn't like this jacket. Hey, I don't know that girl. That damn jacket. She said it's white. The shoes white. I wore these shoes. And I wore this little all black jump. She said, put the damn shoes on. And that, I said,
I'm saying, because you don't gotta be all bitchy.
Y'all, so this is the outfit she picked out. That's the jacket. I really didn't care for it, but it was actually pretty cute. All right, there is the outfit, and here is the food. Thank you guys so much for watching, and have a nice day.